According to the youth, it's been 2 years since Ugandans entrusted their votes with the NRM party to take over the country. The big question, however, is on how far the NRM has lived to its promises when it comes to serving the young people.
We're also trying to assess what should be done as the young people in order to help also the resistance to achieve its mandate in terms of serving the young people. We are having two questions that we are answering today. The question of unemployment that is persistent. The movement promised jobs, we're asking how far. The issue of integration of East Africa, how much has it been going on and how is it affecting the young people of this region? So basically, that's why we are here today, is to check how far has NRM lived to its promises when it comes to the young people of this country.
Speaking during the reflection meeting of the NRM Manifesto Week today in Kampala by NRM youth leaders, the youth demanded for more visibility in government programs, especially the parish development model and the ongoing skilling programs.
In terms of skilling the young people, we are university graduates, but most of the university graduates are not skilled in another thing, and realize that we continue to put up factories and still bring in expatriates. So I want to ensure that we have more skilling in this country and also ensure that the young people know more about the benefit of skilling and modern agriculture.
Emphasis should be put on mentorship, youth should be mentored, because we are seeing a number of youth are battling with mental issues and also skills, providing skills. We have discovered that most programs we are using at universities, the systems are not okay. Let us collect the university system, the education system first. Let the curriculum be reviewed for students to be provided that specific school skill. Even if you go out in the field, you're qualified for that job because you have the you're capable.
Ambassador Nekesa Barbara Owundo, the NRM National Treasurer, highlighted various youth programs that the NRM government has extended to the youth across the country, including youth livelihood programs, parish development model, youth venture fund, and youth skilling hubs, among others. She challenged the youth to embrace these programs.
The youth livelihood program, the money is in that program was a rotational fund. So this fund had been repaid by the youth up to a tune of 20 billion. And from the women, we had managed to collect about 14 billion. This was giving us a total of 34 billion lying in our account. So we felt that to begin with, yes, we may not have a fresh allocation from the Minister of Finance, but we went ahead to plow back 34 billion into these programs. And we also added an additional 6 billion. Now that was for the ending financial year, which has been 2022-2023. So we plowed back 40 billion, the 6 from the initial, from the fresh air release, and the 34 from what had been recovered, because this is money that we expected to be brought back and also lent out to other youth groups.
This meeting ran under the theme NRM Manifesto, tackling unemployment and the East African integration for a productive and engaged youth populace. How far? Report compiled by Jaliat Namoya for the news.